Fantastic.
And they have set aside some money to help us computer train seniors. And it's kind of a one-on-one training. We're going to have coaches that can do some one-on-one training with seniors on computers. And we've already signed up the Fredonia Share and Care. I think it's St. Anthony's? Ooh.
Whoever it
Where
is,
do the
Sharon Kent.
Fredonia seniors
It's
meet?
right in this pack of stuff here, but
But we're going to have that as our one site that's hopefully going to start fairly soon. And then we're working out to have a site at the James Pendergast Library starting in January. They're going to be reopening in December. They've been undergoing renovations. So we're really excited about this program because there's so many seniors that have difficulty getting on the computer and looking up things on the internet. They don't take advantage of email or Google or a wonderful thing called Skype. Do you know about Skype?
You get a free phone call out of them too.
Yeah, they're a very inexpensive phone call, but you can also set it up with a camera. So if your grandchildren are in California and you're in New York, you can actually see them as you're
Actually, you can
talking to
get a
them.
little $25 camera, which you can hook up very easily, and you can talk to them, and there's a voice. You go into Yahoo, you can talk to them and watch
And
them
see them,
on
right?
So it's like a visual telephone.
Yes.
It's
My
incredible.
husband, every Saturday, talks to his mother in Greece. And when my son, the one who's in the Marines, he was stationed in Okinawa, Japan for 2 years. It was wonderful to be able to see him as we were talking to him on the
And you
phone.
can really, it's just incredible. It's all free too, I might add, if you do it
Well, it's
right.
about $30 a year.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I've got it. Yahoo's free. You
Well, I'm computer illiterate, so Linda can learn that and then teach me how to set that up so we can doing that.
Well, you need a new
Exactly.
computer, you know.
I've got children in California and Arizona and Florida and New Mexico, and this will give me an
Well,
opportunity. They won't then
you have a
have to meet.
famous couple of grandchildren too, as I recall.
A couple of
The
grandchildren. My one is
Front
on
Street
my
How is
one's
your grandson doing on Dancing with the Stars?
He's doing quite well, although they keep holding his feet to the fire. He was going to have a film crew come in and have me make some comments this weekend, but something happened. The deal fell through. Maybe it'll be next weekend. I'm not sure, but
They found
I'm
out
very
how
proud
old
of
he
him. He's
is.
doing very well.
They discovered he's almost 90.
Wonderful.
You know, it's
it's a real challenge to talk about. It really takes courage to get up in front of it. I think the last audience they said was 21 million people,
Wow. Well,
and
you know,
dance. And when one little mistake, and it's goodbye, Charlie. You know, boy, I'm really proud of his ability to do that. I was talking to Nick yesterday, as a matter of fact, and Nick is also very proud. He's in England right now, in the UK, as he put it, and they're touring with the Backstreet, and they're drawing 8,000 people per concert. So he
Holy
says he's doing
mackerel.
very well.
Well, the other one, what's his name again? Ringo, or?
That's Nick. That's Nick
Now
Carter.
tell them who your grandson is that's on Dancing with the Stars, because I know a lot of people don't know there's a local connection.
That's Aaron Carter, and he was here in the spring. And he said after the show's over, he's going to come back for an extended visit. So I'll get a chance to critique him in detail.
Yeah, take him muskie fishing too.
So Aaron, watch Aaron on
Yeah,
Dancing
you
with the
bet.
Stars.
Well, he's been a very busy
He's
guy.
still in there. He needs some votes. He gets the approval from the judges, but he needs a larger voting
So
base. He
anybody
doesn't have
listening, if
the
they voted for Aaron, it would help him.
Well, the Osmonds, of course, have been on ABC forever, and they have a voting base of the Mormons. Monday night is family night for the Mormons, so he gets the enormous number of votes. It's going to be
How
almost
about
impossible
that?
to dethrone
Right.
Donny Osmond. Besides that, he's a very likable fellow.
Yeah, and each family has a lot of people in it too, the Mormons, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you, Doug Spaulding, very much for your comments.
Nice to hear from you, Doug.
And Linda says hello, and she'll see you on Monday. Or
Okay,
no,
terrific.
I think she's taking Monday off because it's our 30th wedding
Yeah, well,
anniversary.
that's when deer season
Oh,
opens, you know.
congratulations! 30 years,
30 years.
wow,
That's
that's
30 years.
wonderful.
Right.
Okay, Doug, next Friday over in Westfield, they're going to have a turkey party at the Exempt Hall in Westfield.
Okay.
Don't miss that.
Okay,
It starts
thanks.
at 7:30, and you'll win a turkey. I guarantee it.
Win a turkey.
Yep.
Okay. It's hard to do that. Being a turkey, it's difficult to win one. A bad joke there. I'll let you go.
Next Friday,
Have a
November
good week.
13th,
Bye-bye.
7:30 at the Fireman Exempt Hall. I hope everybody gets over there. You going, you get a turkey. See, I'm there. We can fix it.
Okay.
It's a big wheel. It goes round and round and round. Okay, good morning, caller. Are you still there? No, the new caller's gone again. All right, we'll keep waiting.
Well, let's talk about dining out since you're talking about food.
How do you want to go to a fancy restaurant and have a big, wonderful dinner for nothing? Go ahead.
Well, not for nothing, but you know, as many people know, Office for the Aging, actually one of our core programs is nutrition. And that was how Office for the Aging started, as a nutrition program. And with the money we get from the state and federal government for nutrition, we help pay for Meals on Wheels, and we have many congregate meal sites across the county. And some of those are working so wonderfully, and we're not going to change that at all, but there are a new breed of seniors who are not taking advantage of our congregate meal sites. So we wanted to figure out how we could reach more seniors and make sure that they're getting good nutrition. And this is a program that started at other places, and we thought this is just a terrific thing. So we have, right now, three restaurants that we're contracting with for the Senior Restaurant Dining Out Program. How it works is we have developed a menu with these three restaurants. It's a special senior menu, and we do that. It's been done with our dietitian so that it meets one-third of the RDA, the recommended daily requirements, okay? And seniors can get tickets from Office for the Aging for a $3 donation. And they can take these to these restaurants, the participating restaurants, and get any meal off this menu. And it's a full,
that's included,
full meal.
Say, now we're talking about a Black Angus steak, right?
Well, there's all different kinds of things.
Okay.
You can get breakfast, you can get lunch, you can get dinner. Most of the restaurants have not put any stipulations when they can't be used, except for one, their
sounds
Friday
great.
Night fish fry.
Sounds great.
The three restaurants are Meaters in Ripley, Dutch Village in Clymer, and Grandma's Kitchen in Cassadaga.
There you go.
And we hope to bring on Tom's, the Rowdy Rooster, and the Dinner Bell very shortly.
Oh, there you go, Marianne. So. Wonderful program. Do we have a caller?
No, I got 2 minutes.
We got 2 minutes. Holy mackerel. We
just time got... flies.
I heard that. We're out of here.
Wow.
Okay, close up. Quick close.
Well, I just want to tell people one last thing. As you know, it's been almost a year since Mac McCoy passed away. And many seniors still feel very sadly about his untimely death. And over the last year, we have been working really hard to do something to keep his memory alive. And we have developed a fund at the Community Foundation.
Fund for Mac McCoy.
So it's the Mac McCoy Office for the Aging Memorial
Fund. I want to thank the special people, including you, Marianne. Thank you for coming. You come again
thank
soon?
You so much. You sure.
Okay,
I'd love
terrific.
To come back.
We never even got into a lot of things.
I know.
I want to thank Chuck Kelsey, Devin Taylor, all these beautiful people such as Chris Burke, Chris Remaker, and Mort Flexer, Randy Burke, Roy Harvey, Jeff Zuck, and Don Zins. All these folks, and there are other people I didn't even mention. Everybody that called in. Sorry, caller, we didn't get your call, but yeah, she'll be back. May all that is proud and true and noble abide with you. Do not forget our wonderful veterans on the 14th of November. Veterans Day. I'm Reed Powers.